Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Josh, and this is your stimulus check update for the next stimulus package for Sunday, November 1st. I hope everyone is off to a good and safe start to their Sunday so far, and that you all had an enjoyable Halloween. I can't believe we're already starting November. This year has really just been something else. So in this video, I'll be discussing updates in regards to the next relief package and the second stimulus check. I'll also be discussing unemployment. When McConnell, Trump, and Nancy Pelosi are saying the next relief package will be passed. And then I'll be wrapping up this video by answering some of the comments and questions that I received in my previous video. But first, if you wouldn't mind real quickly liking this video, giving me a big thumbs up. It really just helps with the YouTube algorithm in terms of pushing this video out to other viewers like you, and hopefully helping other people like you as well. Okay, so even though Nancy Pelosi and Donald Trump are pushing for another relief package to be passed during the lame duck session before the end of this year, Mitch McConnell, on the other hand, expects more stimulus to arrive at some point in 2021. So again, we see mixed signals coming from our lawmakers in Washington about this next package. We have our current sitting president urging for more stimulus in November or December at latest. We have our House Speaker also urging for more stimulus to take place within the next month. But then we have Mitch McConnell saying, nah, we're just going to wait until next year to pass something. Of course, it is also entirely possible that McConnell is simply trying to be the realistic one of the group, because let's face it, if they haven't been able to pass anything over the past 6 months, it's hard to see much changing in November or December either. Also, during a lame duck session where it's entirely possible Trump may lose the election and we may have other lawmakers who won't be in office next year either, there won't be as much willpower to really get anything done. If Trump does win, on the other hand, the chances of something getting passed before 21 are much, much greater. In fact, President Trump has already come out and said there will be a tremendous stimulus package immediately after the election, which, of course, he expects to win. Though, I also have to say, it's hard saying how quickly we will actually receive the results. Will a winner actually be declared on election night, November 3rd? Or do you think we'll have to wait a few weeks for an official winner to be declared? What do you guys think? Will a winner be declared on November 3rd, or will we have to wait on a few states to count up all the votes? Also, who do you guys believe will win the election? Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments section below. So that's obviously going to be the biggest barrier to getting this package passed before the end of this year. Who wins the election? If Trump loses the election, there just won't be as much motivation to get anything done, and Steve Mnuchin will probably entirely give up on negotiating with Nancy Pelosi. Also, with Mitch McConnell not having as much urgency to get anything done, it's hard seeing him introducing any new bills in the Senate either. Now, if President Trump wins, there's still no guarantees of anything getting passed before 2021, but we'll at least have a much better chance. The other barrier, of course, is the breakdown in the relationship between Nancy Pelosi and Steve Mnuchin. The two once seemingly had a pretty good relationship. With all the divide politically, those two were actually making some bipartisan agreements and had made some agreements in the past. But now, since Mnuchin is pretty teed off with Pelosi about releasing a letter to the public before he was able to read it, it's hard to say how good the relationship is going to be moving forward. The trust is certainly no longer going to be there as much, especially on Mnuchin's side. Now, Nancy Pelosi did shrug off any personal tension between her and Mnuchin, saying that it doesn't matter what the relationship is, it only matters what the truth is. She said the truth is that this administration has failed miserably in responding to the virus. While that may be true, it doesn't mean you throw Mnuchin under the bus during the process of trying to reach a compromise. That certainly isn't going to make Mnuchin and the Trump administration more willing to give in to your demands. So with all the uncertainty in the air with the elections coming up and the impact that it may or may not have on more stimulus, we just have to continue hoping for the best. The good news is that there really isn't a question on either side whether additional aid is necessary. Lawmakers on both sides of the aisle, Democrat and Republican, have repeatedly mentioned there is definitely a need for another relief package. The only difference is how much each side wants to spend and what they want to spend the money on. So whether or not there will be another package isn't much of a question. What it really comes down to is when they'll finally pass it, and that's truly up in the air. At this point, at very latest, I'd expect a relief package to be passed within the first quarter of 2021. At best, I would hope at some point in early December, but that of course would take a lot of factors going our way. As always, I'd strongly recommend that everyone continue to contact your state lawmakers over the phone and email. Let them know just how important passing another leaf package is to you and your family. That's the only way we can make a change. Get out and vote for politicians who are going to do the best for our country, and also contact your lawmakers and let them know what you want to see happen. In mass numbers, we can definitely make things happen. In the meantime, let's hang in there, stay as strong as we possibly can, and hope for the best. In unemployment news, with every state officially exhausting all their benefits from the Lost Wages Assistance Program, all of our attention is now focused on Congress to pass another bill to extend these benefits on a longer-term basis. In addition to that, the PEUC and Pandemic Unemployment Assistance Programs are also expiring at the end of the year as well. Now, it should be interesting to see the job numbers from October to see where our country currently stands as far as unemployment goes, but either way, we should definitely have a long ways to go. With that said, let's hope that by the end of this year, we can finally pass another bill to bridge the gap until we can get our unemployment rate back down to pre-pandemic levels. Okay, so at this point in time, I'm going to move right along to answering some of the comments and questions that I received in my previous video. And if you do have any other comments or questions for me, please feel free to leave them in the comment section below. I do try to answer as many of the comments and questions as I possibly can, but for those comments and questions I'm not able to respond to, I do try to pick some of the more popular ones to answer in the next video in video form. Okay, so without further ado, let me go ahead and jump into the first comment of today's video, which is from RL. RL says, "Are essential workers going to get hazard pay from the very first time the virus outbreak happened until now?" Thank you for your question, and even though there has been some talk of hazard pay in the next bill, more than likely, in the end, there won't be any. This is simply because the size of the bill being reduced, and although some lawmakers are pushing for hazard pay, there simply won't be enough room in there for it. So not only will there more than likely not be retroactive hazard pay, but there probably won't be any type of hazard pay at all. This, of course, is extremely unfortunate because essential workers were the backbone of our economy during all this craziness, and they definitely deserve to receive a little bit of extra money for their efforts. Okay, moving right along to the next question of today's video, which is from Ligia. Ligia says, "Hi Josh, is it too late to claim the first stimulus check? Is there a deadline for it?" Thank you for your question, and it's definitely not too late to claim your first stimulus check. In fact, there are still millions of Americans who are eligible for it that still haven't received it yet. If you are eligible for the first payment and you haven't filed a tax return within the last 2 years, then you should go ahead and fill out the non-filers tool on the IRS website by November 21st in order to receive it this year. Once you do that, you can use the payment portal, which is also on the IRS website, to track your payment. Now, if you forget to use the non-filers tool by November 21st, you'll still be able to receive your payment, but you'll have to claim a $1,200 credit on your tax return that you filed next year. Obviously, the sooner you receive it, the better, so I'd strongly recommend to go ahead and fill out the non-filers tool as soon as possible. Okay, moving right along to the next question of today's video, which is from Julia. Julia says, "Are we ever getting a second stimulus package?" Thank you for your question, Julia, and even though it has been taking a very long time for this to pass, it should eventually pass at some point. There's definitely a bipartisan wish for additional stimulus, but the amount of aid the two sides are requesting differ by quite a bit. Also, the ways in which both sides want to spend the money also differ. So, all in all, the wish for additional stimulus is there. It's definitely bipartisan, but they're unfortunately just unable to agree on anything yet. Okay, moving right along to the last question of today's video, which is from Megan. Megan says, "Question, what are your thoughts on retro payments for unemployment? Specifically, do you think that they will go retroactive from the last week of July or the first week of August? Or do you think they will be retroactive from when the 6 weeks of the $300 plus up ended?" Okay, thank you so much for your question, Megan, and from everything I've seen so far from the proposals, the unemployment would be retroactive to right around September 12th, which is when the 6 weeks of payments ended from the Lost Wages Assistance Program. Like you mentioned, this is pretty unfortunate because for one, not every state was able to send out the full 6 weeks worth of payments. Some states, for example, only gave out 3 weeks of payments. South Dakota even flat out declined the money from the Lost Wages Assistance Program, so their residents didn't receive a single penny. On top of all that, there was a requirement where you needed to earn at least $100 in weekly state unemployment insurance benefits in order to be eligible for the $300 plus up, so some people didn't receive any money from the program either. But I guess that's the way it's looking to be. It doesn't seem very fair to me, but at this point, I would be happy to see the unemployment benefits extended either way, even if some people will unfortunately miss out on some of the weeks from August. As always though, this is subject to change, and I will definitely make sure to keep you updated one way or another. Alright, so on that note, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video. If you did enjoy the content in this video, and you'd like to see more videos like it, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. It is completely free to do so, and it's a great support to me. Also, if you'd like to receive 2 free stocks from Webull, with both stocks valued all the way up to $1,600, please feel free to claim those 2 free stocks by clicking the link in the description box below. And until next time, I'll see you guys, and I hope you have a great day today.